because this is the way people are. You tell them, I give you this big mansion, there are 60 bedrooms, they're all yours, but this one room over here, you're not allowed to enter. What's the first thing on his mind? Only how do I get to this room? Nothing else, he has lots of rooms available, not interested. He wants the one that is not available. Then it says in a Kabbalah, in a secret, it says all kinds of expressions. It's the wisdom of the secret, of the sod. For those, there's expression of love to Hashem. Like a romance between a follower to the creator of the world. To those who are glued to him. Dvekim, dvekim, dvekut. It's called dvekut in Kabbalah. There's an expression called dvekus. Like the Ashkenazim say, dvekus. It's dvek be'Hashem. It's based on the verse in the Torah, V'atem ha-dvekim be'Hashem Elokechem, chayim kulchem hayom. Those are you that are attached to Hashem today, they're all alive. Meaning, those who are not attached to Hashem, they're not really alive. Then it says, when a person that is dirty from his sins and from his horrible traits, horrible personality, horrible traits, corrupted, arrogant, angry, full of ego, so much pride, jealousy, stingy, selfish. What else you cannot say about this person? A real low life. And making horrible sins. Horrible sins. No Shabbat, Lashon Hara all day, making fun at people, taking advantage on people, stealing, wasting seed, all these horrible things that he does. You want to teach this high, pure secrets of Hashem to such a filthy person? Even logically, it's not working. Forget about the restriction here. Even if there was no restriction, it's something mandatory. Well, how do you feel such criminal? How do you bring criminal like this and teach him such secrets? Someone like that, you have to teach how to be a human being. What does it mean pride? What does it mean anger? What does it mean, you know? This is what you have to teach him. What does it mean Shabbat? What is the violation of Shabbat? You know, you teach them like most of my lecture. 90% of the lectures are about the main ordinary things that every person must know, Jews and non-Jews. So it says, people like that, you gotta be very careful by giving them certain secrets. That's why I was always wondering, how come some Hasidim, they take someone who just yesterday became a Baal Tshuva and run to teach him Tanya. And you're teaching him all this high, holy book. It's not for their level, Bechlal. You have to first teach them how to be people. Then you teach them how to read Hebrew. Most Israelis don't know even how to read Hebrew. Then you teach them how to read Rashi, because without Rashi, you don't find left and right in the Torah. And it's this foundation that they teach in for 4 years old kids. They begin to teach them the ABC, pre-1A, first grade, second grade, third grade. Those are the ages that you get the foundation. How to read, what does it mean, Mishnah? You know, you begin to learn it. These people can be in their 30s, in their 40s. They have to teach them these things. Better late than never. But you can't skip it just because you think, well, look at this older guy. I'm going to waste now time to teach him Rashi and to teach him how to read. Right away, push him to Tanya. What are you pushing him to Tanya, Bechlal? Tanya, Likutei Moharan, Ari HaKadosh, you know, Tomer Dvora, Rabbi Cordovero. What is these people have to do with these things? You teach them Mesilat Yesharim with translation, with explanation. Simple. What does it mean, the purpose of life? It's beautiful. They begin to understand a little bit what's going on. Yeah, you need patience. You can't jump right away to the highest levels. Maybe they have an answer why they're doing it. But from all the years I learned, I didn't see one source that allows such thing. To take a person and teach him the highest level of Torah before he knows Aleph Bet. Does it help? I didn't find any person that it helped him. Maybe there is, I don't know. I never found. I think it's a total waste of time. Same thing I think, that if a person became religious today it's for the first time you accept on him to start keeping mitzvot, you also don't push him Gemara in high level. You first teach him, you know, ordinary things, and slowly, slowly, if he comes to the yeshiva, okay, so now you know at least you have plenty of time. Then you have time to teach him, so you can begin to teach him in a level of beginners. If he will not come to the yeshiva, you have the 1 or 2 hours that he comes to learn per day, what are you going to teach him Gemara right now? First, you have to teach him Parashat HaShavua. At least once in his life, let him read the Torah from the beginning to an end. And he understand at least Parashat HaShavua. Then you teach him Taryag Mitzvot, Sefer HaChinuch. Sefer HaChinuch went all over the 613 Mitzvot with beautiful explanation. Then you teach him Shulchan Aruch, or at least Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. In the beginning, maybe first year is better to push lots of halachot that at least he understands what to do on a daily basis. Kitzur, it's a brief version of the Shulchan Aruch, the Jewish Book of Law. Just to the point, 1, 2, 3, 4, next chapter, 1, 2, 3, 4, we'll go one chapter after the other. Shabbat, brachot, tzitzit, talit, tefillah, kosher food, meat and dairy, things that a person needs for every minute of his life. Eventually, you begin to go serious, like the learning has to go and to become more serious. So you make a beautiful combination. On one hand, you teach him the Torah, the Chumash, the 5 books of Moses, with Rashi explanation. Then you also teach him, when it comes to Musar, you teach him Mesilat Yesharim, Path to the Just, with good explanation. Then you teach him the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, Halachot, 1, 2, 3, 4. You make a nice seder with him, half an hour, half an hour, half an hour. You break it daily. You'll be very, very surprised in 3, 4 months, this person will know already a lot. Because it's like drops that leaks. One drop and another drop and another drop. You come in the morning, the bucket is full. Each drop looks like nothing. Every day would look that he made a little step forward, a little. But after 3 months, you begin to see the difference. It's a combination. Then you move into Mishnayot. You begin to teach him Mishnayot. Not Gemara yet. No rush for the Gemara. Gemara, it's time consuming. To finish, for someone in his level, to finish 1 page of Gemara may take a month. If you take a beginner and teach him 1 page of Gemara and he see that it takes a month and he see there's 4 more 5,000 pages waiting, what do you think will happen to him? He'll break his spirit. Oh, I'm such a loser. Where will I ever finish this? I have to live 50,000 years to finish this Gemara. If it took me 1 month to finish this page. He doesn't understand. The first page take a month. The second page takes 29 days. The third page takes 28 days, approximately. The next the page takes 25, 24, 22. And then eventually it will take you 3 hours, and then 2 hours, and then 2.5, and then 1.5 hours, until you'll be Rav Chaim Kanievsky, finish the Talmud and the Tur Shulchan Aruch every year. Like eating seeds. You know how? One after the other, quickly, one page after the other. Rav Ben Zion Abba Shaul finished Masechet Ta'anit in 1 day. The whole Masechet. In 1 day. But his learning was very, very deep. Not like roughly, you know. Serious, word by word, with all the Kavanot, all what the Gemara meant, what the answer is, what was the question, what was the answer, what's the 2 opinions here, how they comply with each other. Everything. Not just barely, just to know what is it about. No. That's not learning. When you learn Torah, you have to be very serious and very pedantic. You don't let details out if you want to succeed in the long run.